Okay, so let's let the fun begin again.
Again.
This is a Santa Fe. It's a classic, Atlas Classic RS1. Now, before I do anything with this, especially when they're used, and this one's used, not much, but used. So I have it in reverse. We'll see just how it's running. And if it was on the track, it would probably run better. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Here's what amazes me. Listen how quiet this is. So the lights aren't working. That's okay. Like I said, it is used. But it's in excellent looking condition. And when they're used, when they're quiet, I don't mess with them too much, but I probably will go ahead and pull the wheels out of this thing, the drives, and clean them and re-oil them and get them ready. So that takes care of the locomotive. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to test the decoder. For this one, I'm going to use, I haven't tried one of these before, but it's, again, it's an MRC for an Alco 539T. It's a 1623. And as you can see, it's a drop-in. And we'll see just how well it fits. These, I usually find that these capacitors are a little bit too large. And that looks like a 6 millimeter or maybe smaller, so it may be all right. So we'll find out when we get in it. We'll see just what we got here. And we might be able to go ahead and stick two speakers in this guy as well, like we have some of the rest of them. Then we'll see how it sounds. But in the meantime, I'm going to set this up, and I'll show you how I test them. Okay, so we're going to use the MRC Tech 6. And its leads are going into the test track. So I've got red on red and black on black with the alligator clips. We'll trace those back. And they come to these two leads. And these are like little tools I've made. So these little clothespins that you see hooked up to the decoder have a wire going through them, and it's bent so it makes contact with the terminals on the other end. So it's already set up on DCC. Now if I was using an 8-pin, I would use this card that I made. Same thing, hook up the red and black to the MRC Tech 6. It's got a 27 ohm resistor in it, just like this one does, to protect the decoder. So this is no more than, now that it's set up, hit 8, which will start it up. There's that noisy Alco the horn, the bell, and acceleration. Now it's not getting feedback, so it's not going to act just like normal. So, but this tells me my decoder's working okay, my locomotive's working okay, so they get all this put together and they don't work, I did something wrong. And it's just that simple. So, for the Tech 6, to stop it, you just hit the button 8, numbers 8, 3 times. 1, 2, 3. And shuts her down. I got to change the battery, and we'll start tearing this thing apart and get into it, and then we'll just do this, not step by step, but we'll come back and look at it every once in a while, see how it's coming along. Well, I didn't want to go 3D, but I did, so we'll stop this and go back to what we're. Getting a little background noise here, but so after cleaning these really well and re-oiling them and putting them back together, I think you can see that they're really quiet anyway. But it just takes very little effort to get them to roll. And of course, what that amounts to is they're clean, they've got these ingredients in them, Lebel 108, soldered the connections, as you can see, taking those clips off, just a little bit of graphite, just a touch of it. I use a solder paste whenever I solder. I've shown that on other videos, so I won't do it this time. But as you can see, bottom line is, if I don't knock it off trying to do it, they roll so easily. So enough of that.
Okay, just a quick, I got some RC56Z drying, especially right up here holding the plug-in for the speaker. You can see I've got the other speaker in, ready to be installed. These clothespins I put in here just for, I use these a lot. As you can see, this one's been modified. That sponge keeps it from turning down too tight on the, DBX9000 that I use when I have to convert a steam that I put in the plug into the tender. It works out pretty good. The lights have been painted black. They're glued in. Again, just using the RCZ56, this stuff right here. What I like about that is you can take it out really easily if you need to remove it using wherever it went to. The Great Plains Pro C80 bonder. Just a drop, let it set for a minute, and they'll come right out. So the bulbs in there are these yellow glow white LEDs by Miniatronics. And you get 10 bulbs in this thing. They do have the yellow glow like the old type headlights. And then you get two sizes of resistors, depending on whether you're going with a 6-volt system, some between 4 and 9, or something between 10 and 16. So this is a 6.5-volt testing the decoder. I know that it puts out 6-volt. I think almost every one of these that I've worked with from MRC has. So I use the 270-ohm resistors, and they work out great. You also have the 470s if you're working with a 12-volt system.
Okay, before we put it together, it's really good to know that everything's working right. It's, you hate to put it all back together and then have to take it all apart again. So I'm using just the MRC Tech 6. We'll hit number 8. That turns it on. That is the MRC speaker that comes with it. It says it's in reverse. The light came on. You can see I need to put a little bit more paint on it because it's basically still a little bit bright. Same thing with the headlight. So another coat of paint won't hurt. Horn seems to be working okay. The bell. We know the lights are working, so we can turn them off. We'll see if it actually goes forward. Can it do? And we'll try reverse. Headlights on. The track's dirty. I know the wheels are clean, they just got to be cleaning them. I love the way these things coast down. Put it in reverse. Warn them we're coming. Go back to forward. Okay. Let me shut her back down again. It's just touching Tech 6, number 8, 3 times. 1, 2, 3. I didn't do it well enough, I guess, on one of them, but it takes 3. almost quiet.
Okay, I had to make some changes. The board was so far forward that it interfered with being able to install the front lights. So it's been moved back. The capacitors, this one especially, was too far back. It was hitting the flywheel. So you can see now it just barely clears it. And the wires underneath there are just barely clearing the flywheel. The front end is, the back end is pretty clean. Everything is installed, the speaker is mounted in. And now we'll just see if we can get it to go together and close.
Okay, we're all back together. It's really, really tight. The resistors on the board are just, the center of the cab tends to look like it might be up just a, you couldn't even get a piece of scotch tape under it, but I know it's not down as far as it really can go, but it looks okay. This right rail needs to be reformed and then probably super glued. It came that way, so, but I'll work on that a little bit. But let's start it up. Put it in forward. Have a bell.
Stick it in reverse.
Give it a light. Kind of warn them we're coming.
What I really like about these things is you can rev them up a little bit. Take the lead off, just like the real ones, they coast until they need the power again when it's replied. Put it back and forward. Reverse. You see the engineer sitting in there. These have such great slow speed operation. Anyway, enough noise. I do like these things. And again, this is an Atlas Classic. This is a knock camera room, Santa Fe, as you can see. And what we've installed is the MRC1623 decoder. I'll never do that again. That's just way too much work to get it in. But I do like the sound of it and the operation, so. and it has its MRC speaker in that was basically modified to fit. So anyway, one last look. She's done. And even with the MRC Tech 6, if I hit the number 8 three times, 1, 2, 3. And she has shut down.
And that concludes the modification of this Atlas Classic RS1 Santa Fe 2397. Thanks for watching.